But there's a few illegal mods that people do to their car. Does it make the car run better? Is it worth the risk of doing these illegal mods? So in this video, we're just going to look at these common illegal mods that people do. And I have to note, they're not illegal in all areas. In most cases, if it's not illegal to do these mods in your area, you'd be daft not to do it. We can't endorse doing illegal stuff. If things are illegal in your area, we won't recommend that you do them. But we can see why some drivers do these mods, particularly in areas where it is legal to do so. What are these illegal mods? Well, most of them relate to the exhaust system, the various filters that are fitted. The engine is a pump, an air pump. It pumps air in, it burns fuel, it pumps exhaust gases out. Anything that's going to restrict that flow through the engine, there's obviously some technicalities here, but generally speaking, if you've got a restriction in the flow either into the engine or out of the engine, you're going to be down on power. It's not going to be working as effectively as possible. Manufacturers have gone a long way to mitigating these problems. The catalyst designs, the particulate filter designs are larger, they're positioned closer to the engine, they benefit from the exhaust gas flows. Exhaust pipes are generally a bit bigger than they used to be to aid flow into these pollution control systems to minimize the amount of power that we lose. But a lot of these things can be a real pain. The particulate filter is not just diesel engines, pretty much everything from about 2018, 2019 onwards, certainly here in Europe, has a particulate filter. These particulate filters work by trapping the particles of soot coming out of the engine. They then go through a regeneration process where they get hot, and these soot particles are burnt off. They're not actually burnt off completely, they're burnt into smaller soot particles. And when these are small enough, they then go through the filter out of the exhaust into the atmosphere. I'd always argue that those even smaller particles are probably just as harmful as the large particles. But that's not a discussion for this video, really. We're just looking at the particulate filter because it's a problem. It's a pain. They clog up. As your car gets older, it's going to be producing more soot. It's going to need this regeneration process more often. And in worst case scenarios, especially if you've used the wrong oil, the filter is going to get clogged up with particles it can't burn off. And these clogged filters really do sap performance and power, and they can be quite expensive to repair. Often they're cleaned, they're removed, cleaned and refitted, and they clog up again. The problem wasn't the particulate filter, it was the engine producing too much soot. Your poor particulate filter was doing its best to filter out this air coming out of the exhaust, but it just couldn't keep up with the amount of soot that was coming in. You can understand why some drivers look to remove the particulate filter or bypass it. Now, if it's legal in your area, it certainly makes sense, especially on an older car. These can be a real pain. But if it's not legal, is it worth risking it? There's all sorts of fines and penalties. We've seen cars taken away and crushed in some regions, which is a little extreme. Most drivers will end up with fairly substantial fines and penalties. Most areas also have an annual inspection that will check that these items are on the car, even if they don't check that these items are working. So find out what the rules and regulations are where you live. In the UK, it's illegal to remove these particulate filters. If there's any sign of tampering, the MOT testers have been instructed to fail the car. But I do know some people in the UK that have got a car through the MOT. So I'll leave you to speculate in the comments as to how it's possible to get a car through an MOT when the MOT tester is looking for the particulate filter. Then we have catalysts. So catalysts are basically similar to a particulate filter in that the exhaust gases flow through them, but rather than trap particles, they create a reaction. So they reduce the harmful emissions by forcing a reaction within the catalyst that changes the emissions that are coming out of the engine. And by the time they get to the tailpipe, they're less harmful. So the catalyst itself can add a restriction. In most cases, in most modern cars, you won't see very much of a power gain by removing the catalyst. Some people have reported that turbochargers spool up a little bit more quickly, having that lower restriction in the exhaust. So they see a little bit of benefit from removing it. But again, like the particulate filter, it's probably not worth risking doing an illegal mod like that for the minimal gains that you'll get. get by removing the catalyst. And there are performance catalysts around. So again, in some areas, you can't even swap a catalyst for a performance catalyst. In the UK, we're expected to have the catalyst, but we do have the option of replacing it with a catalyst that meets or exceeds the manufacturer's specification. So if we get a higher flow catalyst, that will remove the restriction, and that can be just as good as removing the cat altogether from our engine. Another component within the exhaust system that causes a lot of problems on older cars is the EGR system, the exhaust gas recirculation. At certain points in the RPM range, not at full power, at light throttle loads, some of the exhaust gases are being flowed back into the intake. Manufacturers have done this primarily to reduce emissions. The engine is going to run cleaner, but these exhaust gas recirculation valves do clog up over time. They build up with soot, they stop working effectively, they jam open or they jam closed. And when they jam open, that can affect the performance of the car at full throttle loads. When they jam closed, it's just like the exhaust gas recirculation isn't there, and that can actually throw error codes and cause problems within the ECU. Again, one of these questionable mods that people do that is illegal in many areas is to blank off the EGR or to remove it altogether from the car. Interestingly, when you actually look at the emissions of a car that have had an EGR delete, a particulate filter delete, and a catalyst delete, in some cases, if the engine has been well looked after and well maintained, you're using good quality fuel, the injectors are working well, the emissions are often still within the manufacturer's specifications. So there's been lots of comments on this channel and on our site, on our forum, where people have still passed the emission standards without these pollution control systems, which is interesting. Are the manufacturers fitting these unnecessarily? Could they meet the emission standards without fitting all of these items that are going to become a real pain as our mileage creeps up? If you can think of any other illegal mods that people do that make the car run better, please let me know in the comments. I'm always grateful to hear what you guys are up to. Some of you have got quite devious minds. You're always looking for an exception to the rule. So please share those with us. And again, I just have to reiterate, we can't endorse doing illegal stuff. If things are illegal in your area, they're illegal. You can't do them. You shouldn't do them. But we can see why some drivers do these mods, particularly in areas where it is legal to do so. And let us know what the law's like in your area. Is it quite relaxed? Can you get away with doing all of these different mods and upgrades to your engine? Or are the regs tightening up? And is it getting harder and harder to make these changes to make your engine run better? So thanks for watching. Please boot the like button. That really helps us to get out there. If you haven't subscribed, please do so. About 95% of you aren't subscribed to the channel, and that would really help us with the algorithm when it notices there's a lot of subscribers on our channel. So thanks for watching, and I've lined this video and this playlist up for you that you should find really interesting. See you in this next video.